before I start installing the twin tracks, I'm going to establish a horizontal line down here so I can use that to find my studs. And I'll mark on that so I'm not actually marking on the painted wall, and that'll be our reference. So I'm going to install that tape right now for that. And hopefully this 3M tape will actually do the job without causing me any issues. So what I need to do before I install the twin track uprights here, I got my horizontal tape line. I'm going to use that to actually mark on so I'm not directly marking on my wall. I did look at, review some pictures of the wall when it's still open, so I know where the stud should be. But I'm also going to use the stud finders. I have a cheaper model and a better model of the stud finder. I'll use that and everything, and they actually work pretty good. My wife used them to find me. Check that out. Another neat trick you can do to help find your studs is take a magnet, one of these high power magnets, and just start rubbing it up where you think your stud should be. Right there, I got a magnet. It should be roughly vertical to that point. So if I'm going to put a little mark right here anyway, so I can check later on. But when the drywallers put the drywall in, they had to screw it into the stud. So there should be another one right there. Look at that. Almost dead center where I think the center of that stud is. And I'm pretty sure if I go up here, there's another one. So I'm pretty sure that's right on the stud. So that's an easy way to find them. If you don't have a stud finder, just use a magnet. Look for them like that. So you're looking for your studs, a good place to always start is in an outlet, because most electricians will install an outlet next to a stud. So there's either a stud here or a stud here. So I can take my magnet, if I don't have a stud finder, and run up and down here. So obviously the stud is right here on this side of this outlet. As you can run it up here, and I'm pretty sure if I just run up the wall, I'll hit everything. There's another one. And there should be another drywall screw somewhere right around here. I can find it. But you get the general idea. I know that the stud should be here because the drywallers normally do not install drywall screws into open area. It's got to be a stud there. In fact, what I'll do is I'll take my stud finder and I can check it. It'll come across from one side. Wait for it to tone. Mark it. Come across from the other side. Wait for it to tone. Do that again. That looks like it's about right. It's right up next to where that should be. Got tone. So our stud should be about dead center right here. Most of our studs should be at 16 to 24 inches. Look at that. I don't know if you can see that. That is 16 inches, so we have a stud here, a stud here at 16. So if I go over here and they followed this pattern, there should be at 16 inches from here, there should be another stud. I'll just put a little mark right here. I don't know if you can see that or not. If I take my magnet up and down, voila, there's a stud right there. Look at that. Right on the 16-inch mark. I'll take my cheap stud finder this time. Put it up against the wall. Move it. In fact, we'll take the magnet off so we don't get interference. Mark it. See if verify it with the better one. Yep, that other one picked up at the exact same spot. So it should be right about here is dead center where it's at. And if we check with our magnets, it's pretty much close to where we made a guess up. I bet I could run my vertical laser up here and we'll see if we're actually true on that. And as we move down the line, 16 inches from this point, should be able to find another stud. So really, you can see that I'm doing this technically almost without even a stud finder, because I've used my reference of my outlet, figured out which side the stud's on because most electricians install that, and I can just use a magnet and search for where the drywaller put in the screw. So this one might be in a different spot. We'll find out here. I don't see a screw. I know that this was a different, this wall was done a little bit different than the other walls in the house, just because it's an interior wall and it's a pre-done wall. So technically a stud might not be there, but let's see if we can find it. It's got to be here. It might be the wall's just got a different thickness on it. It's had a hard time picking it up. There's an edge or something. Let's try this other one. So we know it's here somewhere. In fact, it's I'm gonna actually put some tape up higher and search a little bit higher on this wall. So I was having a rough time finding the stud down here. I know it's roughly at 16 inches. So I just put a new tape line up here at the top and we'll search for it that way. Really quick. So there might be something down here that's just kind of in the way, interfering with it in the drywall. Mark it so our stud should be dead center right here. Put a little tick on it. Take our magnet just out of curiosity, see if we find, look at that, right above our line. There's that drywall screw. So we know that we're on a stud, so there should be one somewhere right around here. Just gotta figure out where it's at. Oh, there's two of them right there. And there's another one. So we'll continue on, roughly 16 inches over from this point, so we're pretty much right on the money anyway. Get over 16 more inches. And this is where it's going to get kind of interesting over this far over, because if you can't tell from the concrete right down here, this is all new construction. From this side over is old construction. So this is the original wall to the original train room area, out exterior wall, and then we put the addition on, they added it this direction. So you can actually see where it begins and ends. This concrete is a fill. So right here, roughly, I could probably look down, right here where that little notch is, that's where our trade-off is between the old and the new. You can't even tell, they did a really good job. So it's going to get kind of peculiar in this area to find a stud. I don't exactly know where it's going to be, but we'll look for it. And it shows right where I put the line. That's kind of crazy. Let's see if we... So I'm going to put the same problems as before. I'm going to have to run the tape up higher over here. And then I'm going to have to review my pre-construction photos to kind of get an idea what's actually going on behind this wall. So according to this, it says it's picking up something electrical back here. I'm going to have to do a little bit of digging on that. See, I can feel the wall is kind of thicker right here. So I'm not going to drag this on. I'm going to finish this up without you. I'll post a couple pictures when I'm done. I want to show you guys something a little bit odd here. It's kind of making it hard to find this. Is there something here, and it's probably the actual original wall of the house that I'm picking up. Because... And this is about the actual location of the wall to the house going this way into the house. Remember, that's new construction, old construction. Where it was attached to the main wall was right here, so it's throwing me off. I really have to review where my stud is, and that actually is about right. That should be about 10 inches. Look at that. 11 inches. We're looking at 8-inch blocks with furring, probably. 11 inches, 10 inches. So I'm pretty sure that's the actual main wall to the house is what we're seeing here. I bet if I poke my finger out here, I can feel it. So I got to figure out what I'm going to do here and look actually at my pre-construction pictures to figure out where this stud is. I know it's here. There should be one somewhere here, but I think they moved this outlet when they did the construction over, and it's actually nothing. Doesn't sound like anything next to it. It's probably a free-floating outlet. Just using my magnet right here, I found some drywall screws right here somewhere. So I'm going to take a good guess that that's where the stud is. See, look, there's another one. So right around here is a good spot where this stud should be. We'll mark that up a little bit. I don't think there's anything else. And you just kind of wipe it here on the wall. Small circles. And you can feel it just grabs. So there's a gap right here of about 21 and a half. So there's that wall has really messed us up. But we know that we're 16 inches, 16 inches, 16 inches. And then we have this little gap here where the main wall of the house is. Not a big deal. We can still figure it out and change of clothes. I got called out because we had our final inspection. And if you look, signature right there says we passed. Kind of crazy, it's like going back to school. So our house has passed inspection. We are done with the city. It's now officially done on the project. It is. I don't have to deal with the city anymore. So it's my time to do with as I please. So I'm kind of happy about that. Wife's kind of happy about that. No more pressure. And like I said, there's the signature right there. Passed final inspection. That's one thumbs up, two thumbs up. So cool. We'll get back to this in just a second. I don't know what shirt I was wearing for the start of the video, so wardrobe change. Wardrobe change. All right, hang on. Let's get started again. It's always a good idea to take pictures when you're doing construction, especially with digital cameras nowadays. It doesn't cost you anything to just snap pictures, unless you do like I did. I forgot to get some pictures done between putting the studs in and the insulation and the drywall going on. I did take my time, and I actually wrote numbers for wire height and everything on the outside of these post studs back here. But by the time I went back to take pictures again, the drywallers already had the drywall up. So all the numbers and information that I actually marked down is now gone. By the way, I need a haircut. I have to get one of those by the end of the week. So what I did find out is I got the proper marks for my studs. 1, 2, 3, 4. This fifth one is kind of an odd stud because it's actually the old house construction. So on this side of the wall is actually the original house drywall. This side of this right here, as you watch this little magnet move around, is old drywall, new drywall. I don't want to put my double track right here in that seam, so I'm going to move it over a little bit. I have a little bit of area right around here where I can actually run that. And I want to actually put it in the seam. I don't. It wouldn't be a good idea to put it in the seam between the drywall. I don't think it would be anyway, so I'm not going to do it. So I have my studs already found and marked. Next thing I'm going to do is mark my vertical lines so I have my reference, and I'll probably call it a night and do the rest in the morning. We'll see. A nice laser level like this will do fine for most of your work. It's got a vertical and a horizontal line. It's pretty much all we need for basic work, but it does a really good job. So I'm going to actually mark my lines right here take a straight edge. So this is, and it's actually going to end up behind the twin rail anyway. Draw yourself a line. I'll do the same thing over here. Just spin this around. Set my mark. And conveniently, I did a pretty good job. You can see that all my marks are pretty much lining up with where I want this to be. I can see that the wall right here where you put it together is not exactly perfect. It's got a little bow in it, but it doesn't hurt. And remember, this line will end up behind that twin rail, twin slot shelf rack. Move over here. Finish up on the last two studs. And like I said, look at that, my lines are just perfect. Did a really good job finding those. And you can do this with the regular bubble level if you want to find your vertical lines, but got a laser, so might as well use it. Wow, that's actually pretty good. Look at that, right on the money. And there we have our studs, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Because it's that odd set right there, it kind of messed up our wall a little bit. But I think we're good to go. We could probably run our magnet right up this line. We probably hit every, there's a nail. Right there, look at this. You can see each screw in here. Let's see if we can find it. There's one. Yeah. Right. And we'll probably do the same thing right here. There's one. So we're nowhere on the money on all these as I'm bebopping around between here. There's one. There's one. So remember, I set this one off a little bit to one side just so I don't run my screws down into that seam. Somewhere for later use. And I'm pretty sure this stud to there should be either 16 or 24. Yep, that's 24 inches to that stud there. So all the ones on this wall are set, and I'm pretty sure I can check that. 24. Yeah. So all the, and they're not studs over here, they're, I can't think what you call them now, but it's a cinder block wall, so they are a little 2x4 is back there. But set on 24 inches, 16 over here. You found them all. I think we're doing pretty good. As I got a red laser running across my face, all that's left to do now is install these twin track uprights for the bracket supports, and I will do that in tomorrow's video. I'll show you how to do that. It's a real easy job. You don't necessarily have to be putting in layout, just putting in shelving is all it is. You're just putting in shelving for shelving bench work. Hey, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, comment down below, and if you're not a subscriber, subscribe, check out that Amazon mystery link that I have. it's not really going to be a mystery. It's probably going to be one of these tools, a stud finder, laser level, or something like that. But check it out. See what I have in store for you on that Amazon Mystery Link. Also, check out my Patreon page. I installed that because somebody suggested I do that. So I guess you check it out, see how that works. And on top of that, don't forget we still have that 5% discount deal at MidwestModelRouters.com. Check out that link down below. Use that IMRROcom code. Get your 5% discount. And when you do purchase stuff over $100, he does provide free shipping for you. So do all that and check it out. And I will talk to your face tomorrow. See you guys later.